I'm going to do the menu tonight, so we shall start with a light thing, which is a duck salad. And then we will move on to an escalope de foie gras poêlé sur toast, caille rôti et gratin de brocoli et chou-fleur. Yeah. So you are wondering what it's all about. So it's a cooked, I don't know, how would you say poêlé, Tim?
Cooked in the oven.
Cooked in the oven, foie gras, served on a toast with some roasted quail and a gratin of cauliflower and broccoli. Oh. Yes, that sounds yummy. And then we will move on to some cheeses again, which are going to be crottin de chavignon, which is a marvelous goat cheese Justine will tell you about.
Oh boy!
And the more famous brie de mot, that I'm sure you know of. And then we will move on to a crumble aux fruits rouges and et banane, which is a red fruit crumble and banana. So we shall move on to the wines, and two wonderful wines tonight, because it is Margaux and Pessac Léognan, and I'm sure you know at least of about, you've heard about Margaux. But I'll start with Pessac Léognan. So it's one of the youngest appellation they have in that region, because it dates back from the end of 1980s, and since it has the appellation, it is in competition with the Grave wine, but it's a very, very nice white wine. It has a kind of an oaky taste to it, since it's been aged in oak barrels, and it is made out of a blend of Sémillon stuff. Margaux is probably one of the most feminine red wine they have in that region. It's a medium-bodied, supple, and it has fruity taste, while red fruit taste to it, and it's very nice, and you should enjoy it so with the duck and with the foie gras too. So bon appétit!
Oh, why don't you just say cépage? Because I will start off with the little one, which is crottin de chavignon. Now this is made in the Loire Valley near Sancerre. Very nice white wine. And it is a very interesting little goat cheese, because crottin means dropping. But it's only really because of the size, not anything else, so don't worry about that. But this cheese is actually, when it's first produced, weighs 140 grams. Now you're going to get some facts here, so ready with the wine. So it weighs 140 grams, after 4 months it weighs 40.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so condensing all that flavor from a big one into the little one, bite size. It's wonderful, very rich and creamy, and it's goat cheese. Wonderful. That's the first one. Now the second one, the very impressive one, very, very impressive one. This is a quarter of the cheese. So you can imagine the size.
Wow.
And this is Brie de Mot, the king of cheeses, as it was named in 1715. It was named the king of cheeses. Wow, in France. But it has been around for a very long time. 1774 AD, this cheese was documented. That's a long time. Sorry? Well, no, just in general, the making of the cheese. This piece is a little bit fresher.
Only a little bit.
Just a little bit fresher. And Brie de Mot, yep, wonderful, wonderful. Cheese is made in the Ile-de-France only. It is just loved by everyone. Kings, emperors, whatever, they all love it. tourists,
yeah,
just your normal passerby in the street, they all love this cheese. And it has a very, very special poem that I'm going to read for you, but I can't remember because, as you know, my memory's not good. So, I'm going to cheat, but it's okay.
That's okay.
Yeah, but it's still wonderful, nevertheless. So, if I can read my own writing, we will have a poem.
Okay.
Oh, sweetheart mine, I send to you, like to bring all care that's due, this breeze of to make you sigh, to let you know that saddened by your absence, languishing, I'm quite deprived of all my appetite, and that's why I send this breeze, what sacrifice it is to me.
Hazelnut.
Enjoy. Thank you very much.
Woohoo! Straight on!